This is Cask Tech Tips. I'm Mike. Today I'm going to show you how to remove the spindle from one of our cam seamers. You're either doing this because you're taking advantage of our rebuild program, or during a pre-operational check, you notice movement in the spindle bearings. As a first step, we're going to take a 9/16 wrench, and we're going to remove these four bolts that hold the motor onto this red housing. Once those are off, take the motor and carefully place it to the side. Next, we're going to take a 3/16 Allen key, and we're going to take off the four bolts that hold the spindle onto the top plate of the seamer. Once those are out, pull off the spindle and this red housing together. Be careful not to lose this rubber coupling, so place it to the side. Next, we're going to use a 5/32 Allen key, and we're going to take off these four bolts that hold the spindle onto the red housing. Once those are off, take the spindle off and place the housing to the side. The last thing we need to do is loosen these set screws that hold this coupling side onto the spindle. Once those are off, take this piece off and be careful not to lose this little key. Now it's time to install the new spindle. We're going to do everything in reverse. Take the new spindle and install this coupling half onto the shaft, making sure the key is there, and you're going to install it so the shaft is flush with this piece here. Once you have that on, reinstall this red housing, put it back on the seamer, and then do the bolts on the bottom of the seamer. From there, you're going to take this coupling and place it in the coupling half, and then the final step, you're going to place the motor on top and wiggle it until it drops in place. Once you have it there, put the four bolts back on and you're good to go. If you're still struggling, give us a call and support, but we'll see you next time.